What do you think about all these phrases, they terrorise? But be honest, don't just write it off. They terrorise the East End. If you can look at it objectively, did they? Was is there any truth in that?
Well, I can't. You see, the only answer I can give, a colour answer. One answer is this, and I've told people who've never ever done it. If they feel like they terrorise the East End, they might have terrorised villains in the East End. When I say terrorised them, they was frightened of them, not terrorised them. I didn't go around terrorising people. But if you go to Bethnal Green Road or anywhere where they lived, that's the East End, and you see all, there's a, shops all up Bethnal Green, Bethnal Green Market, and go to every stallholder, every shop, and say, did the twins, how would you, feel about it, Craig? Did they used to terrorise you, or did they used to go in the pub to back the winter? And they're all going to say, I've never seen them terrorise anyone. I've had plenty of rows, but that's a bit different to terrorise. And when I say terrorise people,
and that's terrorise is an active thing, isn't
it? That's right. I mean, I didn't say anyone, I never ever see anyone in a pub go, oh, there he are. But I welcome about my wife because I spent money. Mm. That's the answer. But all this terrorised business, they might have terrorised, villains was, perhaps a lot of them was terrified of them, but
that's different.
How did they terrorise people?
But that's different.
Yeah, well, I can't see this terrorising business. I never have. I've never been able to work that out, terrorising.
Because newspapers do use this every
they
time.
They use it, and, well, find someone who they terrorised, you know. I don't know.
No.
I never found anyone. They terrorised.
I can understand villains saying, I wouldn't, I'd leave it out. Don't.
That's
right. I wouldn't.
But terrorise. I mean, it's an example what happened to me, what I've spoke about already, but that's an example. What did they say about me in the newspaper? Gang boss threatens a witness. Threaten? Oh, is that what they call threatening? It happens every day of the week in every office in England. Someone tells someone off. So I told someone off and I was threatening him.
A gang boss.
And it's like when people say to their children, I'll kill you. They don't mean it.
Yeah.
It's just a figure of speech. I'll kill you. How often you say it? I've said it like, it's a, you don't mean it, obviously.
Yeah.
It's what, it's a figure of speech.
Did they have a gang?
Oh, they had a, of course they did. They had all people round them. And when you say, I don't know, the firm they used to call it, used to work in spills, they used to do this. But they, it wasn't like they had a gang go around and knock him up the air and go do this.
Did they have a gang in the sense that there was a meeting place every, we have a meeting of a gang every week?
All it was is that people would be in my house, or they'd go somewhere, they'd go and drink of a night in a pub or a club. There wasn't no sit down and meetings and all this rubbish.
Planning. See, the way that the picture has been painted.
Yeah, it was all the big planning and board meetings.
Now, who can we get now?
Right.
He's on. Well, we'll all go there. All tooled up.
Yeah.
It was we'll like, go and take over that club there.
That's right. It was like, I'll see you in the Crown Pub, or I'll see you up the coaching horses, or I'll see you thing, or come round home in the morning and I'll meet you round home, pick me up, or that's what right. sort of the meetings was. But
who labelled the gang the firm then? Newspapers or...?
I don't know how it ever happened. That's one of them things that you never know. Everyone knew this. The firm they used to call it. No one took notice. But how it all began, I just don't know. It's funny that, yeah, the firm. I don't know where it all come about.
I always thought it was the Richardsons had a firm. I thought it was a Cockney.
It is, because they asked Ronnie about this, you know, in the dock, didn't they? That's like starting. And you had a gang, but they called it the firm. He said, firm? The Cockney saying is, if a factory or a shop or a whatever they call that, a firm.
Yeah, a company.
A firm, like I said. And I don't know what you mean by firm. Yeah, right, if you want to call it a firm, then call it a firm. Whatever you want, I don't care. But don't ask me how it all began. I didn't call it a firm, it just happened. Like when they said a colonel, he said, the colonel, what's that? If they call me, so what? Don't do with me, I'm not a colonel, am I? You know that, obviously, because I went on.
How did he get called the colonel, then?
That I don't know. No. Someone.
Did Reggie have a nickname?
No. Just things, just. You don't never. You never realise where they come from. I don't know who's the first one I ever called him that. Colonel, like. But a lot of people said, oh, not so much to his face, it was behind his back where he said, oh, I see the Colonel, like, oh, the old Colonel, I see him the other day. And people used to talk like that about him.
So is it fair to say that you have never seen your brothers terrorise anybody?
Never, ever. Not terrorise. No, all this terrorise business. But these are the things, all this terrorise. They've terrorised, yeah, they might have been terrorised themselves.
Mm.
Or terrified, we should say, but there's a difference.
You know? Absolutely. One's active and one's passive. You've got...
Well, it's like Danny Green. I think I've put this in the book before. But you can enlarge it again. This recovers being frightened and demanding. This covers a bit of it. Explanation. Don't get me wrong. I'm not trying to cover up. As I told you, if a guy opened a place and they thought it was liberty, they go and say, that perhaps was demanding. Listen, you open in here, you open your house. Now, we want to share. That perhaps is demanding. I don't know. You know what I mean? But that's what they would do, I admit that.
Mm.
But this is
what
the
other reason thing. Would they go and do that to a place? Purely, what, have you owned it on their patch?
You've opened it, that's right. Oh, we've got one here, you own that one? Yeah, on your way, otherwise we want to share, and that's the end of that. Mm. That's the way things are. Mm. Danny Green, I'm walking one night, Danny Green's talking to the twin. Danny Green was a big Jewish fella, plenty of nice, well, plenty of nice few quid, you know, a gambler. And he was going to open a place. What was it called? The Green Sunning in Stoke Newington. So I come in, he was talking to me, and Ronnie went, No, talking. And he went, well, anyway, Dan, I'll see you in a minute, because I want to talk to someone over here. And they go and walk away, the twins, and sit down, talking to someone. I said, hello, Dan, how are you? He said, all right. He said, Charlie, I've got to have a word. Can I have a word with you in a minute? He said, what's the matter, Dan? He said, I'm worried now. I said, what? He said, look, now I've got the spiel, just opened the spiel, I've opened this nice place. And I just offered the twins a share, and they want to take it. I said, hmm. I've got that place, they don't want to know about it, I suppose. He said, Charlie, but, you know, I'm getting worried. What have I said? What about the twins? I said, if you're worried about them, they'll take a share. He said, no, I don't mean that. He said, you know what they are. They stole the jack, the lads, he said. They'll come in there and it's all going lovely. One night they're going to come in and someone's going to start and ruin me business. He said, if the twins have got a share, they ain't going to come in and ruin me business. He said, directly walk in there, I can't say now the twins own this because they don't. And if the twins found out, are they going to get you up with me? He said, so I want to have a share. Then if anyone comes and say, listen, don't cause trouble. Otherwise, you better go and see the twins or I'll ring them up and tell them you're in there. That way, I'm not going to get any trouble. That's the difference. So he went, to ask them to have a share. You have a word with them because have a share. Now, that's not demanding. That's doing someone a service, right?
Yeah. But that's the fear. You can't, going ahead of them.
That's right. But you can't say, now, they can't make excuses and say, oh, the twins, if there's a row in there, oh, the twins done that. Why would the twins do it? Because he's already off the share anyway, without any trouble. You see what I mean? And I said, no, Danny, we don't. Get on with your spill, thanks, mate. We don't want that. Of course, anyway, at the finish, they did. Because I said, look, I've just had a word with Danny. He's worried out of his life. I said, if you don't like the place, give it a month or something, but have a share with him. Anyway. Dan, all right. I said, Danny, go and have a word. They're gonna. Oh, thank God for that. Lovely. So he went right. Okay. Like, I'll give you a few quid a week. And he said, I'm happy now. Like, well, I'm happy now. And get on with your business. I ain't gonna have no problems down there. Because you do get lots of idiots going around, don't they?
Mm. They wouldn't if they knew the twins.
Oh no, they wouldn't. Poor no one.
What sort of money would a share represent?
In them days, I don't know. It could have been 100 quid a week, was it? No.
But did the money come from shares in places, or did you actually own places yourselves? But you own the Billy Hall, the Double R, the Spieler across the road in Wellington.
Oh, yeah. Then after that, it was Kentucky, the Starlight.
Regency. Did you?
They had a share in the Ritz. We had to rent the gambling downstairs, didn't we? Not a share in the club, in the gambling downstairs. Not the drinking club, didn't have a sharing.
Yeah.
Had the gambling concession downstairs.
Right.
But
lots of shares in places.
Oh, yeah, yeah. And also owned lots of places.
Yeah.
I mean, they had a share in the colony, didn't we? With your graft and that, you know, and...
So what sort of...
Oh, just the Cambridge rooms. That was ours, wasn't it? The Westman. Me and the twins, Painey, wasn't it? And all that,
What sort of money? I don't think John Sykes touched on this. What sort of money would be generated into the, say, the Kray, into three of you? Not that you were in equal shares.
Well, in the years ago, say for instance, that's the best time to remember. Like the barn and things like that. I mean, the barn was getting about £400 each a week out of
the barn.
Days of everything, the barn, the Kentucky, and the other thing.
What were the barn murder was?
Oh, no. Esmeralda's barn. Esmeralda's barn. Oh, Esmeralda. It was very famous, wasn't it?
Yeah.
In Knightsbridge, in Wharton Place. In them days, you're getting like...
£400
a week. It was a lot of money, you know. And just going, blowing it, and saying those.
That was 10 times a good salary, that was.
Giving it all away again, you know what I mean? And spend it. Had to spend a lot in them days anyway to keep up with the people you were with for.
But would you like to have a stab at the figure for what was coming in?
No.
Maybe not off the top of your head now, but if you could give some thought. Because I think that a lot of people... Well, this is the question I'm coming round to. A lot of people who I've spoken to over the years who knew that I published the first book and that I've mentioned to certain people at the Express that I'm going to be tied up doing this, a lot of them have said, have they got a lot of money sorted away? They must have earned fucking fortunes.
We did, give it away. So, as I've explained to you, it wouldn't matter what we earned with Ronnie, he'd have blown it anyway.
But I think it would be a good...